Gout has been known since antiquity, historically referred as disease of kings or rich man's disease. The reason for this misperception is that overindulgence in food and wine has long been thought to be the primary cause of gout. While it is true that diet is related to gout, the notion that only the rich get gout is not fact. It strikes people of all social and financial backgrounds. Currently, more than 1 million people, almost all male, women rarely develop gout. It develops after menopause. The disease usually appears age group 40 to 50, although it can earlier and later ages. Gout is a joint disease that actually doesn't have much with a joint, but it's deposition, something that doesn't belong to joint, causes all of our problems. The big toe is primarily affected, but can affect all joints here. It's described as pedigras. As worse kinds of pain and acute gout inflammation, this person can't walk. Their big toe will be swollen like this. The culprit here at the little crystals are called monosodium, urate sodium, and it's a crystallized form, uric acid, which is something that is normally in our body when exceed affect joints. Understanding gout crystallization relationship. Crystal growing is both fascinating and easy to do. Simply dissolve a bit of table salt in some water. Place string inside and then let water evaporate over a few days. As less and less water is present, the concentration of salt will increase. However, water cannot dissolve an infinite amount of salt. Therefore, there must be maximum saturated concentration. At that maximum concentration, salt will not dissolve, but instead will solidify to form crystals on the string. This is an awesome phenomenon to show your friends, but imagine crystallization occurring within your body. In people who have gouty arthritis, a compound known as uric acid begins to form crystals inside joints, which leads to intense pain. In fact, the pain is so severe that many who suffer from a gout attack described even weight of a bed sheet on their affected joint causes excruciating pain. What's the reason for the formation of these crystals in the table salt example? Crystallization only occurred when the concentration of table salt and water exceeded a certain point. Similarly, uric acid crystals form only when the concentration of uric acid in the blood is too high, which is known as hyperuricemia. What causes hyperuricemia? Uric acid is a byproduct of a breakdown of our DNA and RNA, but when for some reason there's too much, it crystallizes. Defines previously, and it goes around our body and gets stuck in this joint, and whatever joint is stuck is going to be painful. The big toe is commonly affected and has its own name called podagra. The group of people that most often get gout, if we're trying to look at statistics, is going to be males and usually a little older, on the older side, say 50 plus people. Say has to do with lifestyle, and one of the treatments for gout is lifestyle changes. But on a path of physiology level, anything that increases uric acid is likely to lead to symptoms of gout, which we call it erythema. It's red and swollen, any way that we think of it as a joint disease. This metatarsal joint, but the deposition is actually also in the surrounding tissues, as well this intense inflammation here. Also cause the area to feel hot to the touch, so the symptoms and the history should give a lot of good clues in diagnosing. White blood cell count in erythrocyte sedimentation rate, which measures how fast red blood cells become sediment. But these are inflammation markers, and this one is a marker of how active our immune system is. So both of these can actually go up even without an infection. White blood cells we think of as a marker for an infection, even though this is not an infection, because these crystals are not bacteria, are not pathogenic. But the immune system, it elicits, can make these numbers go up as well. So even though the history can be very characteristic of gout, we want to do these tests to distinguish it from other things that could be like infectious arthritis or their autoimmune rheumatic arthritis. The inflammation, these are not specific. You can use these a lot of immunotype diseases. And here we can use homeopathic system immune system, among other things. But in gout, actually, the first thing they should do is to have a lifestyle change, reduce protein intake. There is also a genetic component to gout, which progression homeopathy can control but stop it. But there's also a lifestyle, also part of things to improve, and it's actually hard to separate the genetic from the lifestyle. By thinking of the uric acid, we want to help them do things that decrease the uric acid to begin with. So eating less meat, drinking alcohol, organic things. Pseudogout, how different from gout? We want to talk about pseudogout. It's named because it looks very much like gout, but it is not because of the deposition of the crystals in the joint. So first of all, instead of being in the big toe, whereas you think of gout as more likely to happen, in the knee. So instead of being in the toe, we have all the same problems in any way. The pain, the redness of swelling, the temperature. That's why it looks like gout. But the thing that's deposited is actually completely different. Instead of monosodium urate, we have calcium pyrophosphate. See if I can fit this whole word here. Pyrophosphate dehydrate. But most people probably just want to use the acronym. And that's why you'll probably see at a CPPD. So there's nothing to do. So it's a very different pathway, different deposition of crystals. And for the diagnosis, we actually go through the same system to distinguish the two instead of needles. When we look at these, this fluid under the same light, they're going to be the wrong Boyd-shaped crystals. Instead of a thin needle, it's going to be weakly positive birefringent. So this is the whole reason that we care about it. Because the birefringence tells us whether pseudogout or gout, and also the shape of the crystals in treatment, also largely follow the same themes. So we treat the symptoms, the pain, and the anti-inflammatory things are the same. And by the way, steroids. Instead of taking oral steroids for both an allopathy, which damages kidney in the long run, while at the same time, homeopathy medicine improves kidney health. You can inject steroids into joint space, right to where the pain may provide faster or more stronger relief. But since you pseudogout, we're not dealing with uric acid, and prophylaxis here obviously doesn't apply pseudogout. It's somewhat less common than gout. And so for the purpose of having the correct specific treatment, also for following the disease in the long run, we really want to distinguish between gout and pseudogout before we proceed with drugs. We're measuring the levels in the blood, but the tissue levels can remain high for some time and take longer to fall than those in the blood now over time as the tissue levels of uric acid fall. So will your attacks of gout. Unfortunately, this can take 6 to 12 months. There are a few gout rules that we have to follow to make sure you get the best possible treatment and result number. Dr. Maka protocol. First of all, treat the acute attack of gout before you start to mess with the TAPS or lower the uric acid level number in blood primarily. In gout, uric acid increases higher than normal level. When body cell broken, more part of aging, we can improve progression by slowing aging process, which is decreasing uricase production. Secondly, we need to control food intake, as purine diet, peas, meat, eggs, soya, basically increase protein in body, which increases acidity. Levels of blood cause stiffness, weakness, like lactic acid does. So low purine diet also helps in increasing uric acid level. third level, we improve kidney efficiency to secrete extra amount of uric acid through improved kidney without affecting its efficiency. If we follow all above points, Dr. Mucka protocol, block formation of uric acid tendency in body. Dr. Mucka approach to gout treatment is more of a totalistic approach. Homeopathy helps in controlling the pain during the acute attack of gout, as well as helps in preventing the reoccurrence of such episodes. It helps in reducing stiffness and improves the mobility of the joints. Homeopathy is very strongly suggested for the treatment of gout. Ted suggested that emotions can overcome genetics. The studies show that even those who are genetically predisposed to gout can avoid the disease by staying emotionally healthy. If you are at risk for gout, you can avoid getting the disease if you stay in good condition physiologically.